to everyone. A very good morning to everyone and welcome to today's webinar on resume design skills and interview techniques and preparations. And the topic of webinar will be resume design skills with interview techniques, and we will see around 8 different points related to that topic. Even though it's a Sunday morning, you know, everybody is looking for an outing, but still investing a little amount of time in such a huge achieving skill, which will not only help you in 2 years, 3 years, but it's a lifetime learning thing. So investing an hour to learn this, I think that is acceptable to all. So with a warm welcome to today's webinar. And it is conducted by the OHR. As all of you are aware that OHR is primarily an informal self-help group of and for the HR professionals, including those in IR and allied professions, as well as researchers who have passion to do better all the time. Indian industry has the capability and potential to make a huge contribution in building better India. OHR believes that now HR professionals need to be ready to help industry achieve this goal. OHR, that is the only HR, was started 8 years ago as a self-help group. A few sensitive and enthusiastic HR professionals experienced a need to help themselves and others in their professional community so as to give better results in their respective organization, as well as to rise to be a better partner and community of HR professionals who desire to make an effective and efficient contribution towards building a better organization. OHR connects to thousands of HR professionals working across various types of industries. Every month, a session is arranged for sharing knowledge and experiences in the industry. We have so far made 93 such sessions and various training programs for corporates as well as open houses, that is both the offline or the online training programs. It is overwhelming to see that we have been able to positively influence thousands of HR professionals, that we are now not only becoming a trust, but trusted name in HR fraternity. We invite you to become a part of this knowledge sharing journey by becoming a member in one of the WhatsApp groups, or there are very different ways wherein you can be a member to it. And the last was the 93rd, and this is the 94th session of resume building and learning different techniques of it. We all know the importance of first impression, right? But the chance to get first impression is through your resume. That is your faceless conversation with a stranger. It could be a recruiter or anything. So you might be able to understand how important, you know, getting in place is the resume is. So with this, I welcome today's speaker, Mrs. Siley. She is a MPM, PGD, PIC, BCom, DCA, SAP certified. She has a 9+ experience of years of experience in the HR field in the various automobile industry, worked in many HR functions like payroll, safety, training and development, security compliance, even management and performance management. You also have knowledge of IATF, TPM, EMS, OHSAS, certified author, auditor, and she also worked as senior executive HR in Hitachi Automobile Limited, Private Limited, and also senior executive HR and admin in the JBM Group. She was also the senior HR Pune Polymers in the Pune Polymers Private Limited and the executive HR Politics Electricals Private Limited. Welcome you, ma'am. So please take over the stage.
It's really a good presentation. And thanks for giving a nice information about me. And I would like to say thanks to Prashant Ithapre, sir, that he has given me opportunity to give training on resume design skills. Even I would like to thank to all OHR team that they have given me your time and opportunity to give few knowledge about present time itself. So, hello friends, good morning. Actually, I worked in many more automobile industry, and I have handled the recruitment function. By handling this function, I came to know that there are many candidates, they don't know how to design a resume. There are so many mistakes. And as a recruiter, I faced many problems from contact file numbers, from their address. There were many problems. So as a HR, I have guided many candidates that you have to develop your resumes as such. So it will reduce the headache of the recruiter. But when I was on that platform, it's a very limited scope to give information to all these professionals that what recruiters are facing the problem while shortlisting the resumes. So I have shifted my career to this resume designing. Even I have been training in different soft skills, even IFF related HR clauses, then POSH related training, then communication skills, TPM 8 pillars. So such type of training I can give, even resume designing plus interview technique. Many students, they are facing this problem. They have a knowledge of their field. They have worked in their domain, but they don't know how to crack the interview. And what are the things they have to keep in mind? So I felt ki I have to move in a different direction, and I have to give guidance to the people and candidates. Even experienced people, they have this problem. So it's a very simple funda that how you have to crack the interview and which things you have to keep in mind while designing your resume. So I will start my presentation. Before going ahead, the presentation should be in English or Marathi.
English.
English. Obviously English, yeah.
Okay. Now I will start from resume and CV. Many people are in fact advocating what is the difference between resume and CV. Previously, in olden days, candidates used to write on the heading of the that resume, like resume or curriculum vitae. But now that style has been eliminated. People directly start writing their resumes by writing their names and contact details. But as a professional, I must tell you that what is the difference between resume and curriculum vitae. Generally, resume include all the information of job seeker, like professional summary, career objective, education qualification, then soft skills, technical skills, training attended, work history, personal details. So all these information which is required for the getting job. So all those details are included in this. Then what is in curriculum vitae? In curriculum vitae, all these information is included, but instead of it, the job seeker is having any different type of scholarship, or if he had written any books, or if he had done any case study. If applicant is from medical field, they need to do a case study. So they used to write the case study in your resume. So in curriculum vitae, if you have an extracurriculum activity, you write those activity in a curriculum vitae by adding all other information which is included in a resume. So only this is the minor change in curriculum vitae and resume. And curriculum vitae actually used in medical field, education field, people are using it. Otherwise, resume, all other manufacturing people, IT related industry people, they are using the resume. But nowadays, the resume and the level of migrate used to write on the head of the job.
To interrupt, can everyone please mute themselves?
Aniket Kokare, please mute your mic.
Okay, thank you. Sorry to interrupt, please continue.
So this we have seen the difference between resume and curriculum. The next is contact details. In contact details, you have to write three main points. First is your address. In address, I have found that people who are having a native place of Kolhapur, Satara, or any other, they write their permanent address in the resume. And if they are working in Pune, they don't write the address of Pune in the resume. So I will suggest those candidates who are coming from their native place for their jobs in the city, they have to write the, both the addresses. The reason behind it is because recruiter always checks the addresses. Whether this, if we call that candidate for the interview, that distance of his temporary address and to company address, is it okay for that candidate to travel? Whether the company is having traveling facility for that location. So recruiter always to see the address. So when you write both the addresses, it will be easy for the recruiter that really that person is from Pune location, Kansraj location, or Chinchwad location. So it will be easy for the recruiter to get the proper address. In this address also, I will suggest that you have to write the full address. Many people, they just write down a very short address. So I will tell the candidates, you write the full address because most of the companies, they may make a, what you can say, they can use that address, the company can use that address for further communication. Even in many appointment letters, they used to write the address. So for safer side, you mention the full address. The flat number, the area, the PIN code, the what is in your location of your house. So write the full address, permanent and temporary. The next point is mobile number. Now most of the organizations, they give active mobile numbers to their employees. So employees, what they do, they write those company related mobile number on their resume. I will suggest don't mention your company given mobile number to the resume. You should have to buy your own personal mobile number and then that number you have to mention. Because after you leave your company, that mobile number may be to the other person. So that recruiter may call to that person. So it will be a very bad image. So I will suggest you write down your personal mobile number on your resume. And I will request, because most of the time when we call to the candidate, many times the mobile is unable to reach. Sometimes the mobile number is given to mother, father, or their sister. So it will give a bad image of you. If you have your mobile number, you have to give your mobile number only and not your relatives. If you have two personal mobile numbers, mention two personal mobile numbers because it will reduce the time of the recruiter and they will call you on another number. If one number is busy or one number is not reachable. So in such situations, two mobile number will help you. So even most of the time, I have observed, they had written a very wrong mobile number. Sometimes I found only 9 digits are available in mobile. So these are few mistakes, and we feel very bad for it. That how to inform these things to that candidate. So I request you, you have to check it out, because recruiter will call you on mobile number. So your mobile number should be correct, and it should be reachable. Then third important point is email. Now I used to, when I used to do the recruitment, if there was not a mobile connectivity, I used to send email. So your email ID should be proper. There should not be a spelling mistake. Otherwise, most of the time I used to draft the interview call letter, and their email ID may be some mistakes were there, and that mail comes to me. So it was a mailer failure domain. So this causes a very bad cause to the that candidate. So candidate should get the call, interview call he should get. So his email ID should be proper, correct, and it should be reachable. And now everyone is having mobile. So whatever, if they have, they are getting an email, they should have access. If anyone sends you the email regarding interview call letter or offer letter, that candidate should have access to read that email. So this is all about contact details. I have told you the mistakes, what professional people they are doing. And contact details should be very nice in a precise and correct way, because this is the only source of calling you. They will contact you. So this should be in a proper and correct. Now next session is career objective. Very often I have read so many nice career objectives, and very high-five words they are using. So whether really is this your career objective? So you ask question to yourself, what is your career objective? Career objective will not be the same for whole of your career. It should be in a change. You have to design your career objective, whether it will be a short term, long term. So you should know what are your career objectives. So whatever it means, even I have to work in an IITF certified company, that may be your career objective. I have to learn the AutoCAD, that is also your career objective. So you should know what is your career objective, and you have to write it down on your resume in your own words. You don't have to copy paste. You don't have to use very high-five words. Even you can write it in numbers. It will be very happy. Recruiter will be very happy. Yes, but this person knows where he has to go. So what career objective you have to include? Short-term goals, long-term goals, and what you can contribute for the growth of the company. Few people, they are writing, yes, I have to develop my knowledge, I have to develop my skills. The company will say, hey, we should hire you to develop your skills and knowledge. Then what will be our advantage? So you have to write down as such, hey, what you can contribute for the growth of the organization. So you have to decide what are your short-term goals, what are your long-term goals. If you have to become an assistant manager, deputy manager, write it down. Let recruiter should know, the company should know what are your career objectives. And career objectives should be in 3 to 4 lines. Because you have, recruiter don't have time to read your resume in a very deep. They see the keywords. If you are a graphic, they see the what keywords used in a graphic. If you have bold few words, recruiter will read those bold roles. So I will suggest you in career objective, it should be very short, precise, and what you have to achieve. So even I have written, you see in a presentation, want to work in IIT certified company, seeking managerial level position, have skills and knowledge which can contribute for growth of the company. So you have to write your own career objective and no copy paste, please. Okay. Next point is professional summary. In professional summary, you have to write down in a short in which area you are working. Means in short, your core competency. Many people don't know what is core competency. Competency is a very huge subject. Competency means skills and knowledge required for that job or that position. And third one is immovable, that is your attitude. So you should know what are the core competencies for your position. If you try to write those competencies in your professional summary, it will be best. Most of the time, most candidates, they forget to mention the total number of years of experience. Means I have 10 years of experience. I have 15 years of experience. Now recruiter will count what? How many years of experience you have? No, they don't have time. You have to write down how many years of experience in your field, in which function. In function, I will say core competencies, include the core competencies in your professional summary. It will give a very good impact on the resume in the mind of the recruiter. So, in professional summary, write at least 5 to 6 lines. Most okay. Don't write the essay. Please. Recruiter don't have time. They only see the keywords. Their eyes only see what they want to catch. So I will suggest you, he write down the keywords of in a very short, simple way, okay, what you have to tell to the recruiter about your profession. So in professional summary, you have to write down core competencies, total number of experience, and about your function job in a very short. Okay. So now we have learned about contact details, then we have seen career objective and profession. These three topics we had gone through. Okay. It's not too much in a hurry. Everyone is getting what I have to tell you. Now, important thing, the most important thing recruiters see in your resume. And then they will call you. That is work history and your functional attributes. In work history, you have to write the name of organization, then little information about that company. Now, first I will say the order of the organization. If you have worked in 2-3 companies, so the order of your organization should be in descending order. Means the company which you are working currently, that should be the first. And after your education, which company you have joined, that will come to the last. So in this also many candidates are doing mistakes. So they used to write their work history in ascending order. So we have to search out now in which company he is working. So don't they do this mistake. So you have to write down the work history in a descending order. The next thing is company profile. Most of the time there are so many companies in the market, and the technical background, then the nature of work, as a recruiter, that person is unknown about that organization. So I will suggest there are many companies that are having a different technical background. You write down some profile, company related profile in your resume. Yeah, because this company is plastic injection molding. Yeah, this company is sheet metal. Yeah, this company is manufacturing or fabrication related things. So you have to write down the company profile. Company profile is not the date of establishment. No, we don't have to do anything about that date of establishment. You have to write the nature of industry of that company. So it will give a knowledge to the recruiter. He got connected with that company which is having that type of a background. So it will help recruiter. He might be having that type of a knowledge. If I take a maintenance engineer from plastic injection molding, and he already worked in a plastic injection molding company as a maintenance engineer, so it will help me to understand, no, he is having experience in plastic injection molding maintenance field. So write down the company profile in a very precisely in a short form. Even you can mention the website. Now there are many big companies, Tata Motors, Mahindra. For that, no need to give an introduction to the recruiter. Recruiter knows the functions of that company. But many small scale, medium scale companies are there. So they don't have website. So you can include the customers. You write down the turnover. So it will gives a very good impact that you are connected with that company who is having this type of concern. Suppose the XYZ company is there. That company is having customers like Fiat, Mahindra, Tata Motors. So you automatically got connected with Mahindra, Tata. You know their requirements. Indirectly, you know what they want. So if you write down the customer, it gives that message also that you are indirectly got connected with those companies. And now there are few companies, they are IIT certified, ISO certified, even EMS also certified. There are so many certifications. Even you can write that certification also. In a very simple, yeah, this company is IIT certified. So what recruiter will think, yeah, that candidate may be having knowledge of IITF related audits and activities because his company is having that certification. So indirectly, you are giving such information to the recruiter. So I will suggest you in work history, you start mentioning company profile in a very short. So the recruiter or the person who is taking the interview will came to know he is connected with this type of company which is having this type of customers, and that company with this certification is having. So this is about company profile. Next, your designation. Most of the time now I have started my journey as a resume developer. I found that a few applicants insist, ma'am, I want such type of catchy designation in my resume. So I suggest actually whatever designation is given in your appointment letter, you write it down. No issue. If that word is not HR business, business partner, he used to suggest me, ma'am, please write HR business partner in my resume. And actually, in appointment letter, the designation was different. So I will suggest, please whatever the designation you have in your appointment letter, write it down. And most of the candidates, they are having that type of fear, I don't know what. Many candidates, they are working on a contractual basis. So such type of candidates are asking, ma'am, what we should write in our resume. So I will suggest, because to work in a contract, it's now new industry norm. And everyone knows that no one can give you directly on a role. You have to do it, you have to take an experience. So people are having that, when I discuss with those people, they really feel very pinched. How I will work in a contract? So by counseling them, by mentoring them, I used to suggest, no issue. If you are on contract basis, someday when you will take experience, you will be on board. But don't hide that information. You can write the name of the company. Yes, I am working in XYZ from third party role. Write it down, no issue. But few people, they are having that pinch in their mind. But we don't have option. You have to consider the company policy also. But it's important to guide and to mentor that candidate also. So I will suggest those people only. In that case, your company is bit too. The third party person also, and in which company you are working. So now people have started writing such type of things on resume. So don't change your designation, don't change your company name, either it is on contract. On role, no, there will not be any problem. But on contractual people, they have some issues emotionally, and we have to make them confident. So these are the things candidate have to take care. And other thing is joining date and leaving date. In joining date, leaving date, you have to mention the month and year. No need to mention the date. Because we after see the career graph, in which year he has completed his education. After that, which was his first job. Then after that, which company he got. So few recruiters like me, I used to see the joining date and leaving date. I used to see whether he is not having any gap. Because I know people, what people do to hide the gaps in their career. So in this platform, I will suggest you, please don't hide your gaps also. If there is a gap in your career, don't make it it's a block on your career. Okay, it's a life. Everyone is having problems. Everyone will have to face this life. It will not be a stable. Ups and downs are there in your life. So in your career, there might be a gap. Accept that gap and go ahead with a new impression. And don't hide your gap. Because there was one resume, he was having a gap of 6 months. And I had seen, because it was my habit to see the joining date, leaving date, and to see all that graph. So I have observed he had written 2 years. Means he had not mentioned joining date and leaving date. He had written in this ABC company, he worked for 3 years. In this PQR company, he worked for 5 years. So I asked, why you have not mentioned the joining date and leaving date? Then in a very politely and in a very quietness manner, he said, ma'am, there was a gap of 6 months. So for hiding that gap, he had written 2 years or 3 years in different type of reason. So applicants have mistakes, but we have to see why they are doing a mistake. What problem they have and what is the reason behind it. They are doing one of them. So I will suggest, don't hide gaps. If there is a gap, accept it. No one is perfect. there might be problem, and for women employee, they are having gaps. I accept. Even now, if there is a male candidate, they can also have a break. So to have a break, it's not a big deal. Your life is important. Your journey is important, but please don't hide it. That is the main thing. So in 151.15, the first point is the organization, the list of organization where you have worked, that should be in a descending order. Then next is company profile. In company profile, you have to write down something about the company, then location, then customer, then nature of industry. Okay. Then third is designation. As per appointment letter, or if it is third party, whatever it is, you have to mention it. And joining date and leaving date. So all this is about work history. Now we will go to the next is work experience. In work experience, we write all the work which what we have done in the organization. So most of the times we write down the essays. Yeah, you can write down the essays, but in this section I will suggest you really what type of a work you have actually done. That type of work you have to write. You don't have to do the copy paste. If you like any one line of your friend's resume, yeah, that line is very nice. That word is very nice in his resume. I will write down that word. So avoid it. Genuinely from the bottom of your mind. If you feel you have really worked in this area, write down that area. If you have not worked in that area, don't write it. Nothing will be a big problem if you have not written the things which you have not worked. No issue. You have not worked, you have not written. So you can answer the questions what recruiter will tell you. So in work experience, you have to write down the functional attributes, job description, what you have actually done. Most of the candidates, they write work experience after completing company related information. So it depends upon your experience and your work experience, that how you have to write work experience. By combining with the company information, or you can give a separate heading like functional attributes or key result area, and you can write under that all your roles and responsibilities. So it depends upon your job, your roles and responsibilities. So few candidates, they are having a very different type of work in every organization. Now just now I have developed one resume which is subject matter expert, means he is from design engineer. So his functional attributes are so different in each company. So I have to write the work experience regarding the company. Means by combining the company information, I have to write down his functional attributes. So you can write, it depends upon your work experience. How you have to write it. If you are having the same work profile in every organization, supposing HR, if in every company, if that candidate is having same type of profile, so no issue, you can write in a separate mode by giving a heading of functional attributes, and you can write down all his functions. So it depends upon that profile, that how he has to write the work experience. So in work experience, you have to write down the roles and responsibility which actually you have performed. Okay. Then most of the time I have observed people do face the audits, ITF audits, ISO audits, but they don't write it. So I will suggest those people write it down which audits you have faced. If you are an IITF certified auditor, write it down on your resume. It's a positive and very good thing. that you are internal auditor certified. So even most of the candidates, they don't try to customer audits they have to. Means if they have faced Mahindra audits, Fiat audits, so write it down, whatever it means. So audit faced by you should be mentioned in your it. Okay. Then next is Kaizen. Many people, most of the production people, maintenance people, tool room related people, they are having so much of Kaizen. So in your work experience, write down those Kaizen, because it will add weightage to your resume. And the person who is taking your interview, they'll ask question about your Kaizen. So it is your selling point, Kaizen and achievement. You have to tell to the interview person, to the recruiter. It's very important to mention the Kaizen or achievements in your work. Even you have to highlight the words which are important, which should be read by the recruiter. Even most of the time, the language used by candidates is very funny. So I will suggest you write down the present tense or continuous present tense in your resume. Even you can write down the past tense also, depending upon the job. So take care of tense, present tense, continuous present tense, and past tense, which tense you have to use while writing down the sentence. So in work experience, I have to mention you, most of the people, they don't write the reporting to. I don't know why, because reporting to will tell the recruiter that what is the hierarchical level of yours in your organization. Most of the organization, they are having M1, M2, and three or such type of levels. So when you write down the reporting to, the interviewer will came to know that no, he is on this level. So he's reporting to general manager, he's reporting to director. So it will help to understand your hierarchy level in organization chart and your team size. If he is having 10 people, 5 people, it's your capability that you are handling 10 people, you are handling 5 people. So you have to write down the team size, so it will give your potential, your capability issues. Yes, he is handling 20 people. Yes, he is having that type of capability, because to handle the group of 10 people is not a easy task. You have to handle every person's problem. Ma'am, I want a holiday, I want all of these things, I am unable to do this task. So you are handling a team. So in soft skills, you write team player. But how many team size you are handling, don't know. So write down the team size. Okay. And while writing the sentence, you have to start with the verb. Handled, I have good knowledge of, have a confidence, work, handle such type of functions. So please check your resume, ki which and how sentences you have used. Use a very simple understanding in nature, such type of language you have to use, and don't copy paste it. Whatever you have worked, please write that type of work, because the recruiter will ask the question about it. So you should be answering. So these are very important things that you have to write down in your work experience. Okay. Now we will move to the next model, that is education qualification. Most of the time, education qualification we write after work experience. In education qualification, I don't know people are trying their education in a very short mode, like B.Vic, M.B.A. Why you are not writing the full form? It's your degree. You are spending such amount of money for getting that degree. So I'm just suggesting you write the full form of your degree. It looks very good, and it's informative for different person. So write the full form of degree, location, and year of passing. Year of passing is important because recruiter like who, they will check after year of passing, after how many days you have got your first job. So year of passing is very important. It gives very good information to the recruiter. And most of the people, they don't write the percentage. I am surprised why you are not writing the percentage. Whatever it would be, if you got 40%, you write it down. It's your intellectual level you are telling to the front person. You are not writing, people are asking, ma'am, please don't write the percentage. I'm really having a very less amount of marks. Please don't mention the percentage. So if you are paying such amount of money for getting that degree, for getting that education, whatever you are having the percentage, to write it down once. So it will show your intellectual level. See, he is 50% she has got, but she's very good in her work. Let it accept. Okay? And in here, even contact details, I have told you, if you have a permanent address, you write it down. The reason behind is, and the name of college, the location, you have to mention the reason behind. In our India, there is such type of thing. If I am from Satara, and the candidate is also from Satara, this information will provide resume. Recruiter wants, are she is from Satara, she is from Kolhapur, who made it. Native place they hai. She's from my native place. So I will refer her first. So this is the reason people got connected with the native place very easily. Yeah? Even they are passed out from same college. Oh, she is passed out from Modern College Shivaji Nagar. She is my colleague. I have to take care. I will give it to that kind of. She's from my college. She's from my native place. So this aspect a lot. Even from different state also, they got very close friends. Yeah, she is from Orissa. Yeah, she is my friend. I will take care of her. So all these things really affect a lot. We got a very emotional touch with that employee, with that candidate, with that person, whoever it may be. So that is the reason I used to always say to the candidate that you don't know who is the recruiter, who is from which background. He will not know for the interview. So these are the sources. You have to write it down on your resume. Okay. Next thing is training certificate or certification. Now, there are many certifications in the maintenance people, they are having certifications. And, there are many HR certifications are there, production related certifications are there. If you have achieved those certifications, write it down in a full information from which institute you have taken it, how many marks, grade you have achieved, in which year you have achieved it. So write it down. If these are your positive points, these are your weightage, you have to mention in your resume. So this is about certification. Even you have to write down the trainings attended inside outdoor of your organization. Many people, they don't write the trainings attended, because it will help the HR. He is having knowledge of PFME, So I can make him a trainer in my because organization has to reduce the cost. So what they will say, no, I will give this person as a trainer. So if you have training attended, mentioning it, it will help the HR to develop the training calendar. So write it down in which organization, the indoor, it was the indoor training or outdoor training, whether you have a certificate or not. If you have a certificate, write down the date. If you have grade or passing grade or any other type of evaluation, you write it down on your list. So this is very important, certification and training attended. The next is achievement. Achievement is such a means if you really have got an award, if you really have got a certificate, then only you have to mention in your resume. This is if you have participated, that is all your achievement. If you have participated in the program, so that is not your achievement, that is just participation. But you have got any award, you have got any monetary award or any certificate, then only you mention it. And when interview asks you, tell me about yourself. At that time, you don't have to forget your achievements. Then that time is your exam time, that how you communicate your achievements to the recruiter. So in achievements, what we can mention? The Kaizen Award, the safety related things if you have done, or any cost reduction thing project if you have done. So such type of things you have to mention in your resume in a very bold capital that recruiter should read it. The recruiter should answer, should question you about your achievement. So this is very important. Not only you have to write down your achievements in your resume. If the recruiter tell you the question, like tell me about yourself, you have to practice it, how you will answer the question of this question. And if you don't have any achievement, no issue. Nothing to worry. If you don't have achievement in your career path, you can achieve. So no need to worry ki how I will write achievement. If you don't have, don't write. You don't write, I have participated in this program, I have participated in that program. Sorry. Participation is not your achievement. Okay? Next is soft skills or skills. This section is like many candidates are just writing the soft skills just as a kaitari like you only as. So I will suggest candidates keep for your job, for your function, which soft skills you require. You have to first find it out that. For performing maintenance activity, what soft skills that position requires, and out of that soft skills, which soft skills I have. This type of study you have to do. Then only you write down the soft skills. Many people, they don't have a team, but then also they write down in that soft skills that I'm a team player. Okay, and they don't know how to manage the team. So don't do such mistakes. What behavioral skills? You write it down. You go on Google, you search it out. You go on job description, read out your job description. Which soft skills are needed? Okay, so write down a very correct and appropriate soft skills. Just don't write anything what you feel. Okay, whether it is really required for your position are you really connected with that soft skill? How much you will give rating out of 5 to that soft skill? So this is very important and quite practical that you have to write down. Next is technical skills. If there is a design engineer, what you write down in technical skills? AutoCAD, CATIA, then NX, then in that there is a version. So you have to write those technical skills which are required for your function. If you have that technical skills, your function will get high level of knowledge, or it will give a comfort level of that work. It will give addition to your work. It's a value addition to your work. So MS Word, MS Excel, that is also technical skills. You can write it down. Even I am doing PowerPoint presentation, no issue, you can write it down. So these are technical skills, especially designer engineers, they have to write it down in a very appropriate way. Other people, it might be on their own design whether they have to write it down or not. So technical skills depend upon your job. Okay. Next is personal information. A very important topic. In personal information, you have to just mention your permanent address. If you have not written your permanent address in contact details, you can write it down here in personal details. Then you have to write date of birth in a proper way. Most of the candidates, they are having 2 date of birth. So you have to write the actual date of birth which you have a document on Aadhaar card or PAN card, which is having that date of birth you have to give to the organization. Okay, because on date of birth there are many things depend, all other calculations, HR related calculations, then your age calculation, then other, there are many benefits. So that is the reason you have to write the date of birth which is having proof or which is having a document. Next is marital status, unmarried, married. Then hobbies, really which you are having that hobbies. Otherwise, if you had written I have a hobbies of playing cricket, it's okay, no issue. But if you had written hobbies of reading and you don't know the author Shivaji Sawant, so it will be a very false information that you are giving to the principal. And if you don't have any hobby, don't write, no issue. So another thing is LinkedIn address. Now why LinkedIn address? Because LinkedIn is a social site where you write all the information about your career, and it's a public media. So on that social media, you can't write the false information. So HR might check your LinkedIn address to check whether information you have written on your resume, whether it is really true or false. So recruiters like me, they will definitely go through with your LinkedIn address. So check it out, your LinkedIn address profile is with full of information. It should not be only 50-60%. It should be 100% filled. Okay. And prefer job location. Prefer job location is why there are many candidates, they have to work in Mumbai area or Nagpur area. So how recruiters will come to know? If there is a person who is working in United Kingdom and he has to come to India, how I can know that he has to come to India? So prefer job locations. If you have to change your job locations, you have to mention on your personal information. So in personal information, you have to only include this information. Don't write Aadhaar card number, PAN card number, then religion, gender, caste, nationality, notice period, your current CTC, your expected CTC. Don't write all these things on your resume, please. It's really embarrassing. If you write CTC and expected CTC, please, this is not the time to discuss CTC. Let the recruiter call you for the interview. Let them select you for the interview and then you discuss the CTC. But not on religion. And religion? Why nationality? If you have to show your nationality, you can write on your address by writing India. So the front person will understand he is from India. This is his nationality. You don't write caste. So even self-declaration. Most of the people they have read, I hereby declare that although information is true as per my knowledge. And there is a sign. Don't include self-declaration. You have appointment letters, you have offer letters, you have other things. Recruiter will check all other things. Don't write such things. So avoid such mistakes in your life. As a HR, now every person has a different thought. This is my suggestion. So all this is about resume writing, what you have to write, what you don't have to write. So all this is about resume. Now I will show you few of the formats which I have developed. There is a resume, and I changed the few. I have hide few things because it's confidential information. I can't share it. So few things I have changed. See, this was this old resume. Objective summary, education. Technical skills, working experience. Now, he has seen, this was his first company. He had written it here. And current company is here. Sequence is wrong. He had written declaration. No need. This is his resume. After making few changes. Mobile number, design profession in manufacturing industry, address, phone number, email ID, LinkedIn address. Then I have included this career objective plus profession summary. How sweet, concise, only 3 lines. Core competence, how I show. Work history. ISO certified. These are the software, you know. This is Sheet Metal company. And the company is in Pune. talking about his work and it is reporting to handle the team side. Which resume recruiter will select?
The second one.
Now there is an international resume. If you go outside of India, they prefer to have a two-page resume. They don't write essay. Okay. This is one of the international resumes. See how it's including all. And he is having 30 years of experience in one page. It was a 5-page resume. 5-page resume in one page. He has to go to outside India. Competences, how I have written and skills, then work history, how it is. From SCL. This person is higher level. Who is handling SCM function? 5-page resume. Okay, recruiter don't have time. I suggest to this person that he has to reduce few things, but you have to listen to the client. So people, resume writing is very easy task. It's not an easy task. Recruiter has to select your resume out of 100 resumes. Your resume should be shortlisted. So you should understand whether you have to increase the headache of recruiter. You have to reduce the headache. Now this is all about resume writing. These things candidates are doing to check and what things you have to take care, what recruiter are thinking. So let's start next interview. Let me open my presentation. Are you ready for your presentation? Now, interview technique. Now you have developed your resume in a very nice, in a very attractive way. Your resume had for shortlisted. Now recruiter called you. Now, which are the things that candidate has to do? The first, the very first and important thing, if recruiter had scheduled a time date after discussing with you, you have to ensure that really on that day, are you able to go for interview? Are you able to give that time for the interview? Most of the candidates fail in this area. First time they do commit to the HR, that yes, we are going to come for the interview on that day. But all of a sudden, they do cancel it, which is a very bad effort. Because if company is scheduling the interview, they have made the background arrangement for conducting that interview. Many people are involved. If your interview is scheduled on that particular day, from reception, from security, to the higher authority, everyone knows that these candidates are coming today. So I request to all candidates, if you are having problem with the time schedule, whatever it is, you don't commit. You have to tell to the HR, ma'am, yes sir, please give me the time. I will check it out and then I will leave. And when you have to inform to the HR that you are going for the interview, inform through call. Even you can send the email. You give your confirmation. And now, due to this pandemic, most of the interviews, they are through WhatsApp video or Zoom. So online interviews are going on. So for that reason, so you have to be available. So the very important and the first thing is, whenever you schedule the interview with the HR, you have to ensure ki really is it possible for you to attend that interview. Then only commit. And if you commit and then you go back, it will be a very bad thing if you really have to go in that organization for the interview. So next time it will be a very difficult because HR has to once again arrange all those activities. So please ensure it. Then second, you have confirmed through mail, by telephonic confirmation, yes, I am coming to the interview. The next question is, you have to check it out, the job description, roles and responsibilities, and the company. How is company? What manufacturing products are there? Who are the customers? What is the turnover? What is the job location? Then you have to find out the company profile related information. Even you can call to friends, how is that company, is it okay, work culture, or other things. So next step is, you have to find out the company profile, you have to go through with company profile, and what are your job responsibilities, roles and responsibility, key result areas that they are expecting from you. If they have listed you, That means something you have. That is the reason they have Shastri study. So it's your duty to understand what is the rules of responsibility and key result data or functional activity. What are the responsibilities? What they are expecting from you. If HR had not provided such information, you can ask, you can request the HR to, ma'am, please, can you send me that information? So I will make myself prepared. So this is the important thing. But if, for example, in HR, if there is a job responsibility, the company is expecting the HR has only an IR related activities experience should have. If that company's expectation are that you have to look towards IR related. So what candidate will do? He will try to explore himself in an interview IR related activities. Okay. Because HR function is a very big, safety is there, the compliance is there. If they are expecting IR and you are telling safety profile, what is the use? So job responsibility will help you ki what they are expecting from this position. So when they will ask you the question, tell me about yourself, you can answer it. So on which function you have to give a weightage, it will be clear to you. So the next thing, thing is the company profile you have to read, and job and responsibility you have to ask to the manager, ma'am, please give me the job responsibility. Now after that, you might be knowing the job location. She will send you the address. You have to check it out, which are the sources. You have to go for the interview by bus, by train, by two-wheeler, by four-wheeler. How much time it will take to reach from your residential address to the company address. It's very important. You have to check it out, because if there is a 2 hours journey, then at what time you have to move up from your home? If recruiter had given you 11 p.m., 11 a.m., then you have to be there at 10:30. So you have to take care of the timing when you will reach the interview, because there might be other sequences. You will never get the bus. You will never your two-wheeler might get punctured. You don't know the uncertain things. So whenever you are going for the interview, you have to first check it out, the location, how long it is, which mode of transport you are going, and how many time it will take to reach at the location, so you can move out from your home at that time. Okay. Then other thing is your resume printouts, and even that file. You have to at least carry 2 to 3 printouts of your resume, and your that file, mark list related file, that should be arranged in a very properly descending order manner. Even that file is also arranged in a very rubbish, and it is also not properly arranged. So I suggest you ki even that documentary file you have to manage in a very good order, and you have to carry the 2 copies of your resume, because if there is a senior person who decided to take your interview, there should be one extra resume. There should not be any thing like, I don't have a resume. So at least you will carry 2 copies of your resume. Then, that's how I told you, you have to reach at least half an hour before to the interview thing. When you reach on that venue, you have to fresh yourself. You make some what I can say. You go washroom, you wash your face, put some powder on your face. If you have a perfume, just spray perfume sprayed on your dress. If you have a You have to be a very quiet. You should not be a very worried because you are traveling. That stress should not be on your mind. You should be a very comfortable. You should be a very quiet for the interview. And most of the time, dress code. People are having so much questions about dress code. For ladies, I will say, if they are comfortable, then they are okay with the sari. Otherwise, I will not prefer to wear a sari. You can have a simple dress. If you have a good, don't wear the jeans and t-shirts. Have a proper shirt, pant, or a proper good dress. You can wear it. But don't wear jeans and t-shirts for both. Male and female, both. And male, they can have a pension. Even if you people, they are question ki, shall I have a blazer and shall I have a tie on my shirt? It depends upon the company. If company is good, then you can wear the blazer or tie, and you can go in a washroom and you can have proper attire. You can change your attire also because it might be sweaty and all. So if possible, you can carry your whatever is attire and blazer. You can change attire washroom or in company. So all this is about your dress code. I will suggest you when you have an interview on that day, you don't have to keep any work with you. Yes, I have to take a printout. Yes, I have to iron my clothes. No. When you have to go for an interview, you have to be a very relaxed. The day before your interview, your everything should be ready. Even having shoes. I don't suggest to the ladies, don't wear that high heels. Have a simple sandal. If you have a shoes, you can have a shoes which are comfortable to you, but don't use the high heels. Even for male candidates, they can have a proper shoes. Okay, don't wear a chappal and all that. Have a proper shoes which will go or match with your dress. Okay, and important thing when you go for the interview that you should be relaxed. When your mind is relaxed and stable, then only you can deliver what you know about yourself. Read your resumes 4 to 5 times. Connect yourself with your resume. Most of the time, people get blank because they are not connected with their resume. They forgot what type of work I have worked in that office. They have worked, but during interview, they used to forget, they used to get clean. So I think when you read your resume, you somewhat got prepared with what type of work I have done. Yes, I have done this, I have done this. What functional attributes, what achievements I have to tell to the. So all this practice you have to do. And the most important thing is the candidate has to be comfortable and he has to make comfortable to the front person. This is the secret of any relationship. If you make friend person comfortable and you have a good relation, then it will give a good output. If you don't make a comfortable to the front person, no, that person will avoid you. So try to make comfortable to the front person. Be comfortable yourself. This is 90% of your interview will crack. If you make that person to the comfortable, this is a trick. Not only during the interview, if you face any problem in your life, if you have to face 40 people at a time, so at that time you have to be a very quiet, you have to listen what friend person is saying, and then you have to make a comfortable to the friend person. Okay? If you do 90%, you have made a what keeps it? No one will tell you. No HR will tell you. This is very important. But before that, you have to make few preparations that I have told you from your dress, from your resume copies, then that location, how you have to go, decide it. Don't keep any work pending when you have to go on that day. Don't keep any work pending. You have to just get up and go for the interview. Have a breakfast. Have a breakfast. Keep change with you. You don't know what problem will occur. Don't keep 100% online transactions. Keep the change. Have a breakfast. Full heavy breakfast. Because you don't know at what time your interview will conduct. And avoid eating outside food after having your interview. Okay? And which questions you have to prepare for interview? Many people, they are failing. You have to tell about yourself. What information you have to tell when recruiter tell you the question? First, you have name, your designation, which industry you are connected, then your career objective. People, I don't know why do people tell the career objective to the recruiter. Tell your career objective. Then your work history. In work history, in a very short, concise. Then your work experience. Then education qualification, soft skills, technical skills. And in the last, you have to tell the family details. No one follows this order. There are many YouTube channels. They are having this type of video. So I will suggest you, okay, this is the sequence, your name, career objective, then work history, work experience, education qualification, then soft skills, technical skills, if any, and in the last, you have to tell the family. So just tell me about yourself. Tell me about your strength. Many people don't know their strength. You have to tell your strength regarding your function and regarding your personality. So go out, see in the Google, which are the strength points are there. And out of it, which strength point you have. There are strength points. But out of that, how much you acquire, you study them. So many people, they don't know their weaknesses. So you should know yourself. So I will suggest you, you have to prepare for these 5 questions, that is, tell me about your strength, tell me about your weaknesses. Why we should hire you? Huh? Many people, they are free to answer this question. This question is your selling point. At this, what will be the answer of this question? You have to take an achievement that I have done such type of achievements, projects, guides, which have helped the organization to reduce the cost, which helps to improve the productivity of the organization. So such type of projects, such type of cases, I can implement in your organization. So that is the reason you hire them. So in this area, you have to tell your cases, achievement, your award, your project, your cost reduction project, your safety related project. So what financially you can benefit to the organization that you have to tell. Okay, and what will be your expectations? The most important thing. Most of the candidates, they are fail in this. They don't negotiate. If you have to negotiate, you have to demand. You expect your salary or you make a hike on your net pay. Don't demand on your CTC. Because every company is having a different rules, regulations. You don't know the deductions of the company. You don't know what benefits you are getting from the company. So I will suggest you have to expect your salary hike on net pay. Don't expect your salary on gross CTC because you don't know the policy, don't know the legal compliances, what deductions they are doing from your salary. Okay. So this is a very important while interview technique. I do take a mock interview. Due to mock interviews, people are getting very good confidence. So they can face the interview, they can crack the interview. Okay. Now, when video is there, that how that person cracks the interview. I will show you.
The audio is not there for us.
Audio. Do you hear it?
No, it was not audible to us.
Yeah.
Now,
maybe if you can unplug the earphones and play, maybe we'll be able to hear this sound from the system.
Now,
yes, audible. But can it be a little in a higher volume, please?
Yes.
Volume is lower.
Okay.
I
Actually, madam, you have reduced your volume.
So he got low. So all this is about resume writing and interview techniques. In this video, we have seen how he was comfortable and how he made that person comfortable. All questions, all answers, he was ready with. So you have to keep yourself ready with your question and answers. So,
ma'am, if you can move forward with a question and answers.
Yes.
Yes, there is a question on the chat box by Rani. That being a college student, what should be the sequence while introducing oneself?
Okay, your name, your name and your designation with the name of the industry, means design engineer from manufacturing industry. Then career objective, whatever it is, what you have mentioned in your resume, you have to mention your career objective. Then your work history. Work history means the name of organization, descending mode, and then joining it in that, and that little information about that company, and work profile, what you work in that company. Then after that, your education, then soft skills, technical skills, and in last you have to tell family details.
But ma'am, being a college student, they don't have work experience. So I think they can mention so the college functions that
career objective. Yeah, she has to tell the career objective and what she had learned in her academy. So she can give short introduction what she have learned in her academy.
Or add in some like I was the. In the management team, or I was the lead in the invitation for so and so program, which can show her leadership skills.
Yeah,
on
we
her
can,
maintaining
yes,
she, skills.
She had managed or she had arranged an event, so she can tell that also. Even she can analyze herself as in soft skills or technical skills. She can give even academic projects are there. If that student had completed any projects in any company, she can elaborate on that also.
And add internships as well.
Yes.
Since college students. Okay. Rani, I hope that
yes,
answers
ma'am.
The question.
Thank you for this information. Ma'am, I have one more question. If
yes.
The interviewer asked me to tell me about my projects that I have done. So
yes.
How many minutes should I take to explain my projects?
So, there is not any time bound for it. You have to tell about your project in a very short, concise. But important thing is you should able to tell the conclusion of your project. In project, we write down the conclusions, what you have learned from this project. So if your project is having of 3 months, so how you have worked, how you collected the information, who helped you, what exactly you have included in your project, and what you have learned, what your conclusion on that project. So that you have to mention. And don't worry about the time.
Okay.
You have to tell within 5 minutes, 10 minutes. No, it should give you the time to tell what you have to tell.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you, Rani. Any more questions from the crowd? If not so, ma'am, I guess, is it possible for you to add in your contact details as well? It was there in the PPT, so in the chat. Ma'am, you're on mute.
Can we get the video of this whole session? Video recording?
Yes, yes. Because all our sessions we are uploading on YouTube. So you will get
okay.
a link for that. Don't worry.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Any other question?
Sukruti, already it is we are ahead of time. So
yes,
I think you should. You thank you and they if
and
they want anybody want the, any information
the
they can contact
me.
No, it's okay it's interesting but today is Sunday also no
yeah
people are
so anyone in the crowd if they want to contact more know more of the topic please contact Ms. Saili ma'am and the contact details are on the screen. And with this, I would like to thank Saili ma'am for giving the precious time, the knowledge transferring us, helping us with the resumes. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, OHR. The whole team.
Yes, thank you, madam.
Yes.
Very wonderful session.
Yes.
The many new things we also came to know today.
Thank
Shailendra, you. You want to add anything? Shailendra, Sachin?
No, it was a very nice session. Thank you. Really wonderful insights we have got. And most of the mythology about adding the details of whether personal details to be added or not, what kind of mobile numbers to be added, hobbies. There's a lot of questions have been answered. Thank you. Thank you very much, ma'am.
Yes.
And thank you, everyone, for joining and patiently listening to the topic.
Yes.
And thanks, Sukruti, for your wonderful coordination. Right from welcome to thanks.
Thank you so much. Pleasure is all mine.
Yeah, and that is also at the last moment I have requested you. Just half an hour we had our discussion about this session, and but you have done very wonderfully. Thanks for that.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks all wonderful audience also. Even though Sunday, they attended in these numbers. Thanks. Okay then. Yeah. Bye.
Yeah. Bye.
And happy weekend.
Happy weekend, everyone.